In this tutorial, I'll be showing you how to download and install Create Your Frisk along with mods. Timestamps, links, and a written transcript for this video will be in the description below. Okay, we'll want to get started by heading over to 7zip.org so we can pick up the unpacking program needed to open .zip. But more importantly, .rar files which the built-in Windows extractor won't unpack. Depending on your operating system, you can choose the 32-bit or 64-bit link. If you need to find your system details, right-click on your Windows icon on the taskbar, select System, and on the About page, you can find the information next to System Type. For myself, it will be 64-bit, so I'll want the second link. Once the new window is open, you can save it anywhere you wish. I'll save it to my desktop. All right, now that it's finished, we'll go over to the GitHub page where we can download the newest version of Create Your Frisk. At the time of this recording, it is version v0.6.4. Just like how I saved my 7-zip setup, I'll have it download to my desktop. This will allow you to play most mods for Create Your Frisk and Unitail, although there are certain cases where you might need an older version. For example, CYF All-Stars will want to be played in version 6.0.2 or 6.2.1. I'll have links to all of these in the description. Before we get into getting mods, let's take care of setting these two things up. We'll start by installing 7-zip by double-clicking on the .exe setup. A user control window will pop up asking if you want to run 7-zip and have it make changes to your device. We'll want to select Yes. On the setup page, we can see that the destination folder is on your C drive by default. If you want to have it installed in another folder or another storage device, then you can click on the three dots and select any location from here. I will keep it to the default drive, so I will select install. Once done, we can head over to the Create Your Frisk file and right click on it. Go to Open With, choose another app, more apps, and select 7-zip file manager. Make sure to checkmark this box. Always use this app to open .zip files. If for some reason you can't find the 7-zip file manager in this list, keep scrolling down until you see look for another app on this PC. Click on it and a new window will come up. Find where your 7-zip installation is located. So for me, it is in my program files on my C drive where I installed it. Select the 7zfm and then click open. Your Frisk file should have the 7z logo over it now. And if it doesn't, then right click on your desktop and hit refresh. This will refresh your icons on your monitor. And now we can proceed with extracting the file. Right click on Create Your Frisk, go to 7-zip, Extract Files. This will open up a new window where the first box shows the location where our extracted files will be unpacked. Like before, clicking on the three small dots will open up another window where you can choose where you want it extracted. I'll be keeping it to the desktop for ease of use. The second box will have the name of the folder that is created, so you can name it to whatever you prefer. I will name it to CYF and now press OK. We can now double click on our extracted folder and see the various files inside. That takes care of setting up these two things, and now we can get to the fun part, downloading mods. To find mods, you can search for them on Google, Game Jolt, Unitail Reddit, YouTube, etc. You can pause this video and come back to it when you have the mods you want. I went ahead and downloaded two mods. One is Disbelief Papyrus, which is a .zip file found on Game Jolt. The second mod is Meon, which is a .rar file that I found from the Unitail Reddit. I'll start with Disbelief Papyrus by right-clicking on it and select 7-zip, extract files. Just like before, I'll rename this mod folder in the second box and keep the location the same. Press OK, and now we have our first one extracted. Now we can extract Mion just like the previous files. By this point, I really hope that you are starting to understand extracting a little bit and how it works with Create Your Frisk in these examples. Okay, we are almost there. Open up your extracted mod folder and you will see this subfolder that we will want to put in the Create Your Frisk mod folder. I'll do it again with the second mod I downloaded. This process is the same, no matter if it is a .zip file or a .rar file. We can finally start up Create Your Frisk, yay, by clicking the .exe. Once on the main menu, we can hit the spacebar to go to the mod list. Click on mod list at the top and use your arrow keys to select the different mods. We can start up either mod that we downloaded by clicking on it and then pressing enter. There is one important thing. If you download an older mod, you may need to go into the options and enable retrocompatibility by clicking the box. This will make it so your older mods work with Create Your Frisk. And with that, we have gone over how to download and install Create Your Frisk along with mods. If you have any issues or questions, then post them in the comment section below and I will do my best to help out. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more of really what I do on this channel, then feel free to subscribe and leave a like so others can see this video on YouTube. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, take care.